Last speaker, because short of time, Dr. Niranjana Balasubramaniam. She would be presenting on the pattern of visual impairment in a spectrum of hypoxic ischemic encephalopathy. I would request Dr. Shikha to make her comments at the end of it. I think Dr. Santosh is not here. You could share your screen.
A very good afternoon, everyone. Can you hear me?
Your signal is not okay. Maybe you could switch off your video. Yes, share your screen. I'm sorry, I can start here.
A very good afternoon, everyone. My presentation is on the pattern of visual impairment and spectrum of hypoxic ischemic encephalopathy. And I extend my sincere thanks to my professors. HIE is an important cause of permanent damage to neural tissues, resulting in neonatal mortality or manifest with permanent neurodevelopmental abnormalities. We all know the common ocular manifestations in HIE. On a detailed literature review, we found that there is no study so far which has evaluated the interrelationship between the visual impairment, clinical neurological severity, the neuroimaging severity, and the entire spectrum of the perinatal HIE, and also the impact of visual impairment on the social development of these children. Hence, we arrived at the objectives, the primary objective being to evaluate the relationship between the visual acuity and the clinical severity of the HIE. A prospective observational study was conducted with sample size of 60 diagnosed cases, with 20 in each of the three clinical stages of severity, included children between 6 months and 5 years of age, and excluded other acquired encephalopathies. A detailed ocular examination, pediatric neurological workup, and the social developmental quotient assessed by VSMS by neuropsychologist, and all those children who had neonatal MRA were subjected to MRA grading. Binocular visual acuity with Teller and Cardiff acuity after cycloplegic refraction was tested, and flash VEP was recorded. And the clinical severity was classified as per Sarnik clinical staging of HIE into three stages. And the lesions in the MRA were topographically classified, scored, and graded. And briefing on the results, we found that nearly 78% of the study population had a history of term gestation, and birth weight did not have a significant influence on the clinical severity of HIE. And a primary objective of visual acuity assessed by Taylor and Cardiff acuity cards had a statistically significant relationship with the clinical severity of the HIE. And there was no significant difference in the acuity levels between term and preterm children of HIE. And the refractive error was comparable across the clinical stages. And we found a good correlation between Taylor and Cardiff acuity in these children. And comparing them, the grating acuity and the Cardiff acuity with the normative data, we found that our study population were far lesser compared to the standard normative data. And the flash VEP recordings of these children did not have a significant relationship with the clinical staging of the disease. And we found nearly 80% in stage 2 and 3 had a significant evidence of disc failure. And the frequency of nystagmus was almost similar and lesser in stage 2 and 3. And we found that the convergence strabismus was the predominant one, with nearly 53% in the study group having esotropias. And there was a good correlation between the MRA scoring and the Taylor and Cardiff acuity, and also found a significant relationship between the MRA scoring and the clinical severity of the disease. And the visual acuity had a significant impact on the social development of these children. And as expected, the systemic morbidities were higher in stages 2 and 3. On summarizing the results, I would say that HIE was more in term gestation in our study population. And there was no significant difference in acuity levels between term and preterm, and acuity impairment was lesser in stage 1 of disease. There was good correlation between Taylor and Cardiff acuity, and also with the MRE scoring. And the refractive error was similar across the clinical stages, and convergence strabismus was the predominant one. And I would like to recommend that we need a large-scale follow-up studies to correlate the predictive role of neonatal imaging on the future visual outcome in the perinatal HIE. And we need to focus on tailoring the services according to the severity of the disease. Thank you.
Thank you. Dr. Shikha, you can take one small comment.
It's a good study. You did mention that the brain injury did not correlate with the VEP. You have any explanation for that?
Ma'am, it is felt in most of the studies that injuries with anterior visual pathway impairment had relationship in the visual evoked potentials, whereas we see in HI, both in term and preterm, the ischemic insult is more concentrated in the retrochiasmatic pathways. So that might also play a role. And mostly, like most of the studies had pattern VEP or sweep VEP results. So the inclusion of flash VEP was not more relevant. We found it difficult to do pattern VEP and sweep VEP in these children.
Yeah. So if you...
So consideration should be given to that.
Yeah, no, this is not what I was asking. Of late, very recently, they've started looking at, you know, the same ischemia can damage the retina also. So now they are evaluating whether it is the vision loss. In certain cases, it's because of the retinal damage. So, you know, in those cases where the retina is damaged, the ERG is, you know, giving more information than VEP. Anyway, good study.
Thank you.